Shooting particles at a wall with two slits will unsurprisingly result to two clumps behind. But what would happen if you use waves instead? When the waves hit the slits, a new wave from each slit spreads up. These waves then interact, their peaks and valleys combining to form an alternating pattern of parts, where they reinforce each other and where they cancel each other out. This is known as an interference pattern. Now how about we do the same experiment in the quantum world of the very small? Here, I will use a laser that should theoretically produce very small particles of light known as photons. When we shine it against a barrier with two slits, we expect two bright bands to form at the wall behind. But when we do the actual experiment with light, we get this. This, surprisingly, is similar to the wave behavior earlier. So this proves that light is maybe a wave after all. Except, scientists have managed to shoot individual photons, and they appear as clear distinct points. So is light made out of particles or waves? More importantly, what would happen if you shoot photons one at a time against two slits? Would it still form the interference pattern? In experiments, the accumulation of many individual photons do form an interference pattern. But this doesn't make any sense. How does a single particle photon behave as if it is some sort of wave dividing into two? Also, since the photons are being shot randomly at the slits, why are they more likely to hit certain areas than other places? Enter the wave function. Like functions in math, it describes how an event takes place, just like how a parabola can describe the path of a trajectory, or how an exponential function can describe the increasing cases of COVID-19. The wave function, however, can describe every possible location of the photon at any given time. Here, the peaks indicate higher probability of where we might find the photon, whereas the valleys represent its least likely position. But why say possible locations? Isn't it impossible for something to be in two places at once? The dumbfounding idea here is that the photon is in a superposition. It is actually at many places at once, as determined by the wave function. It is only when we try to detect it that it takes a random definite location. So for every photon that is shot to the wall, its wave function or probability wave divides into two. It appears as if the photon is simultaneously taking every possible trajectory, and these trajectories interact to form alternating regions of low and higher probabilities, and at the point of detection, it resolves back to a single particle. If we shoot enough photons, we get the interference pattern. As it turns out, the building blocks of the universe obey superposition. In fact, superposition is one of the foundations of the most successful theory scientists have ever formulated: quantum mechanics.